kimsin? Who knew no sin? That we might become His righteousness. He humbled Himself and carried the cross. Love so amazing. Love so amazing. Jesus Messiah.
Damn. Okay, turn me down. Good morning, New Life Alliance Church. Glad that you are here today. Today's a day of celebration. Can I get somebody to go, yeah! It is a day of celebration. We're celebrating all kinds of things. But I'm hoping that you've gathered here for the same reasons that I gather here. Celebrate Jesus Christ. To lift up Him, to honor Him. Please, 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 it ain't about me. Please, it ain't about our guest speaker that you're going to hear a little bit from later. It's not about the praise team. It's not about the guitars and the drums. And it's not about the padded pews and the carpet and the flashing lights. You know what it's about? It's about Jesus. I'm hoping that's why you've come here today. Because you desire Him. You want to be drawn closer to Him. That's why I come. And I like being surrounded with people that are like-minded that want to seek Him. They want to lift up their voices, honor Him, and praise Him. Would you stand with me, please, this morning? And a little scripture reading for you. Psalm 138. I praise You, Lord, with all my heart. That's a great place to start. It's a great place to wake up every day. Not just on a Sunday. I praise You, Lord, with all my heart. Before all the other gods, I will sing Your praise. I will bow down toward Your temple, and I will praise Your name for Your unfailing love and Your faithfulness. For You have been exalted above all others. When I called on You, You answered me, and You greatly emboldened me. This place, this day, this moment, Jesus reigns. Can I get an amen?
Amen?
Jesus reigns. Let's sing about it. Come on.
It's the song of the redeemed, rising from the African plains. It's the song of the forgiven, drowning out the Amazon rain. The song of Asian believers, filled with God's holy fire. It's every tribe, every tongue, every nation, a love song born of a grateful choir. It's all God's children sing, glory, glory, hallelujah, He reigns, He reigns. It's all God's children singing, glory, glory, hallelujah, He reigns. Let it rise above the four winds, caught up in the heavenly sound. Praises echo from the towers of cathedrals to the faithful gathered underground. Of all the songs sung from the dawn of creation, some were meant to persist. Of all the bells sung from a thousand steeples, none rings truer than this. It's all God's children singing, glory, glory, hallelujah, He reigns, He reigns. It's all God's children singing, glory, glory, hallelujah, He reigns, He reigns. It's all God's children singing, glory, glory, hallelujah, He reigns, He reigns. It's all children singing, glory, glory, hallelujah, He reigns. And all the powers of darkness tremble at what they've just heard. Cause all the powers of darkness can't drown out a single word. It's all God's children singing glory, glory. Hallelujah, he reigns. He reigns. It's all God's children singing glory, glory. Hallelujah, he reigns. He reigns. It's all God's children singing glory, glory. Hallelujah, he reigns. He reigns. It's all God's children singing glory, glory.
Praise be to your name. Glory to your name. Father, we praise you. We glorify you. We extol you. We lift you high. There is no other God that reigns higher than you. You are the King of kings, the Lord of lords, the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end. And Father, we've come to honor you and praise you. And Father, in this place today, I pray that you would work within our hearts, work within our minds, challenge us, change us, inspire us, encourage us, convict us. Father, our desire is to serve you well. And Father, have your way among us in this place, this moment, this time. In the name of your Son, we pray. Amen. You may be seated in his presence. Hey, check this out.
Why you ever chose me has always been a mystery. All my life I've been told I belong at the end of the line with all the other not quite, with all the never get it right. But it turns out they're the ones you were looking for all this time. Cause I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
When Moses had stage fright, and David brought a rock to a sword fight, you picked 12 outsiders nobody would have chosen, and you changed the world. Well, the moral of the story is everybody's got a purpose. So when I hear that devil start talking to me, saying, who do you think you are? I say, I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. You rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
So let me go down, down, down in history as another blood-bought faithful member of the family. And if they all forget my name, well, that's fine with me. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. So let me go down, down, down in history.
Go down in history.
As another blood-bought, faithful member of the family.
That's all I ever want to be.
And if they all forget my name, well, that's fine.
Good morning, church. Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Good to be in the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
All right. You've just seen just about everything that's in this bulletin up on the screen. So I know you observed that. Now you can read this when you have an opportunity. Because there's so many things that we can do as individuals here, right here at New Life Alliance, to help out in God's work right here. And the bulletin has those opportunities listed. We have so. I want to ask you, please, if you can get here this early, we're going to be starting, Brother Spencer's going to be starting the book of Proverbs, 9 o'clock. That should be a very interesting study. So if you want to find out if you have wisdom or not, this would be a great class to come to. So let's check that one out. Okay, I guess I'm going to take this liberty, Pastor. In the middle of this, you're going to see a young man, Asher. I have been accused over the months of trying to talk him into joining the Marine Corps. I stand guilty but not guilty. I mean, God opened the door that he finally walked through. He's going to be on his way. I have been asked a number of times, why do you wear those hats? Why do you military guys wear those hats all the time? Now, most of you have never seen me wear USMC hat. In the Marine Corps, it's not a hat. This is the way they say it. Women wear hats, men wear covers. So, we have covers, all right? And mine says USMC, or it might say 1st Marine Division, Vietnam Veteran. Well, we don't wear those hats for the general public just as, oh, look, come up and thank us, which some people do. I'm going to tell you why, especially as a former Marine or Marine at heart, why I wear that cover. This is when it pays off. No matter where you're at, church, Publix, or anywhere, you're walking, somebody taps you on the shoulder, Semper Fi. You grab that hand and you look eyeball to eyeball, and you know, I've been there, I've done that. That's why we wear those covers. All military service people, God bless them all, pray for them all. No matter what uniform they wore or even wear today, pray for them. They are all very special. But in order to answer that question, because I have been asked that question, why do you guys wear those hats? Because that's what people call them. That's why. So in about 3 months, because I couldn't do it now, because he's not there yet, but in 3 months when he walks back into this church, I'll be able to walk up to Asher and say, tap him on the shoulder or give him a big hug, grab him by the hand and look right eyeball to eyeball and say, Semper Fi. And we're going to be able to see eyeball to eyeball. Been there, done that. Amen? Let's all stand up, walk around, and tell somebody you love them. Well, that's a good idea. Everyone, not just somebody.
All right, 1 minute. one of my favorite parts of church.
There you go. Yeah. Lion and the lamb, baby.
takes your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise to you, only God. You give life. You are love.
Before you, Lord. In this place, Father, we praise you, we glorify, we declare that you indeed are great. Just keep playing that. Great are you, Lord. Great are you, Lord. Somebody say, great are you, Lord. Great are you, Lord. See, this is the place. These are the moments. In the presence, God inhabits the praises of his people. Father, I pray that you would help bind us together, Father. Help us to focus upon you, to be here in this moment, right here, right now. Father, wash our minds clean of what happened an hour ago. Father, wash our minds clean of what's going to happen in a few moments. May we be ever present here and now in your presence. Speak to us, Lord, for we desire you. Declare your goodness. Declare your greatness. We worship you. Speak to our hearts. minister to us. Heal our broken bodies, Father. Make straight our crooked minds. Set us on a right path, Father. There's no place that I would rather be. Right here, right now, in the midst of you. Minister to us, Father. And Father, we pray you would go before us, carving a path, setting it straight, that our spirit knows and can discern that which is of God. Give us the boldness and conviction to follow where you would lead. And come before you in the name that is above all names, the sweetest name of all, the God that reigneth over all other gods. In the name of the Yeshua, Emmanuel, the Christ, in the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. You may be seated in his presence. Is there more? So if you feel the need, you can stand, but worship with us, will you?
The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, let all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice.
Sing with me, come on.
How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. And all will see how great, how great.
How
Sing it up.
How great is our God. Sing with me. How great is our God. And all will see how great is our God.
Father, I thank you for this day. I thank you for the fact that we can come together as a body of believers and praise you openly, Father. Father, I thank you for these people in this church, Father. I pray that you move hearts today, Father. I pray for the speaker who's coming to speak for us, the missionary who has dedicated their life to you, Father. I pray that they show us the love of God that's going on in another place, Father. Change hearts of stone into hearts of beating flesh, Father. And may we glorify you in all that we do. In your name we pray. Amen.
Bless you. Thank you, sir. So who wore white? Did you get the memo? So here's what we're going to do. Asher's getting on a bus or going to be on a bus, heading to Marine basic training. And so we want to pray for that boy, don't we? Yeah, we do. And I think Miss Barbara was inspired. It's like, I don't know, the Lord's telling me to wear white. And I think some of that is because, man, you stand out. And so I want to take a little video of us, all giving a little wave, all saying good luck, Asher, all saying God bless you. Okay? And I'm going to pan from over here to over there, and we're going to see who the rowdy side is. We're going to see who worships God the most. We're going to see who loves Asher. We're going to see who loves Asher the most, okay? All right. Ready? Here we go. All right. Wait a minute. Okay. So can I record self and then flip it, and it'll stay recording and go back to the other way? Does anybody know about that kind of stuff? Yeah, I don't. Asher, brother, we wanted to say we love you as a church family. We're going to be praying for you. And we want all of our congregation to say a little something to you and to praise God. How do I flip back now? See, you told me wrong. You told me wrong. All right, so you know what we're going to... Wow, look at you. Let Asher know you love him from the church family. Come on, let him know you love him. Let him know you love him. Asher, we love you, brother. All these people are saying, hey, goodbye, I love you. I don't know, spiritual signs of it. There's some Marines back there. Some Marines back there, Asher. Asher, we love you. Come on, baby. Come on, the whole congregation. Give it up. Give it up. Give it up, brother. Oh, yeah, we love you, brother. All the best. Woo! Okay. You know what's going to warm my heart really, really good? Is I can see that you can cheer. I can see that you can praise God. And so there might be days when you don't hear it so good. I think we're holding back. Because don't you think we can praise? I just heard us give a glory shout and an amen and a praise and a blessing unto Asher. I think we can do that unto God, can't we? Glory to God. Praise the name of Jesus. Well, I know that we can do that, so you'll monitor yourselves as a congregation. We can do better than that. Praise God. So not so long ago, I think it's not so long ago, but it's been, whoo, decades. I was working a third shift job, pastoring a church and going through seminary. So there were times I wasn't always the happiest kind of guy in the world. I'd come home after working all night, and I'd be kind of tired, I'd be kind of cranky, and I'd not be in the best of moods. Anybody with me after hard days? Yeah. And it never failed that whenever I walked home, walked into my door, there was my dog. And my dog's tail's wagging, his eyes big as a baseball, he's just loving on me. I was like, ah, oh, good dog, good dog. I'd go try to take a nap for a little while, sleep for a few hours. You know, your hair gets messy, have bad breath, wake up, guess where my dog is? Right there. My dog licking my face, loving me, right? Just my dog just loving on me. I'd put on my dress shoes with my shorts, and I'd walk down the driveway to go check the mail. Out in public, and where's my dog? Right there, just loving on me, jumping on me, eyes as big as a baseball, tails wagging. And it hit me. The Lord just hit me hard. Wouldn't it be great? Wouldn't it be awesome if we had a church like that? A church that just dogged you. A church that just loved on you. Didn't matter that your hair was messy and you had bad breath. Didn't matter even what kind of mood you were in. We're just going to love on you. We're just going to dog you. So the church inspired us as a church family to just pull people together and pray over them. So this week we're going to dog on Nancy Lytle. Come on up here. We're going to pray for you. Come on. God bless you, girl. God bless you. I know this is tough for you. You don't like looking out at all the eyeballs. How can we pray for you?
Just for continued health and pray for my family.
Continued health. You're a cancer survivor, aren't you? Let's pray. Father in heaven, I just want to come before you and continue to uphold Nancy before you, Father. As she's been a point of prayer many, many times for this congregation. Father, I just feel the power standing next to her of how God works in someone's life. Father, how you cross the spiritual and intersect and intervene and touch into the physical lives of somebody. Father, I thank you so much for her living testimony. Father, I pray for her continued health, that, Father, she continues to speak and she continues to rise up and testify of what God can do in the midst of someone's life. Father, we pray for her family that's all around her, Father, from children and grandchildren and mom. Father, all those, Father, I would pray your blessing upon them as well. Father, might you continue to work in their lives. Show yourself strong. And Father, I pray that you would use Nancy to do just that. Father, that you give her the heart of compassion and kindness, that she knows what to speak and when to speak. And Father, that you give her wisdom. Give her wisdom, Father. And Father, may her life continue to be that which is a testimony to you. In the name of your Son, we pray. Amen. God bless your girl. And so, did you soap this week? Did you soap this week? All right, so we want to make sure we keep on soaping. Sir, come on, Semper Fi. Read us a scripture. I wanted to say to you, you know, real soldiers wear berets. That's coming from the Army Airborne right there. God bless you, brother.
Did you say berets or berets? Oh, I'm sorry. No. I tell you what, I have seen men in other uniforms. I have been dazzled by them. Believe me, the 82nd Airborne. Like I said, listen. Makes no difference what uniform you wear. God bless them all. Amen. Amen. We do have a guest speaker today, Sister D. That's exactly right, Kruger. She will come up in just a moment, but we are going to read our soap scripture this morning, and then we'll ask her to come up and share with you what God has put upon her heart to share with us this morning. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, New International Version. The nature of true apostleship. This then is how you ought to regard us servants as of Christ and as those entrusted with the mysteries of God has revealed. Now it is required that those who have been given a trust must prove faithful. I care very little if I am judged by you or by human court. Indeed, I do not even judge myself. My conscience is clear, but that does not make me innocent. It is the Lord who judges me. Therefore, judge nothing before the appointed time. Wait until the Lord comes. He will bring to light what is hidden in darkness and will expose the motives of the heart. At that time, each will receive their praise from God. Now, brothers and sisters, I have applied these things to myself and Apollos for your benefit, so that you may learn from us the meaning of the saying, do not go beyond what is written. Then you will not be puffed up in being a follower of one of us or against the other. For who makes you different from anyone else? What do you have that you did not receive? And if you did not receive it, why do you boast as though you did not? I had to get that last word in there, didn't I? Already you have all you want. Already you have become rich. You have begun to reign, and that without us. How I wish that you really had begun to reign so that we also might reign with you. For it seems to me that God has put us apostles on display at the end of the procession, like those condemned to die in the arena. We have been made a spectacle to those, to the whole universe, to angels, as well as to human beings. We are fools for Christ, but you are so wise in Christ. We are weak, but you are strong. You are honored, and we are dishonored. To this very hour, we go hungry and thirsty. We are in rags. We are brutally treated. We are homeless. We work hard with our hands. When we are cursed, we bless. When we are persecuted, we endure. When we are slandered, we answer kindly. We have become the scum of the earth, the garbage of the world, right up to this moment. This is Paul's appeal and warning. I am writing this not to shame you, but to warn you as my dear children. Even if you had 10,000 guardians in Christ, you do not have many fathers. For in Christ Jesus, I became your father through the gospel. Therefore, I urge you to imitate me. For this reason, I have sent you Timothy, my son, whom I love, who is faithful in the Lord. He will remind you of my way of life in Christ Jesus, which agrees with what I teach everywhere in every church. Some of you have become arrogant as if I were not coming to you, but I will come to you very soon, if the Lord is willing. And then I will find out not only how these arrogant people are talking, but what power they have. For the kingdom of God is not a matter of talk, but of power. What do you prefer? Shall I come to you with a rod of discipline, or shall I come in love and with a gentle spirit? I would prefer his last one. I want to come in love with a gentle spirit, with a gentle spirit. That is the reading of our scripture this morning. And now, Sister D, if you would come up and share with us what God has put upon your heart. Is she going to need a mic?
I hope this works.
I just want to make sure we can hear you good.
All right, can I be here?
Sure.
All right, good. I have one right here. All right, my name is D. Kruger. My husband Mark and I have been working in Guinea-Conakry, West Africa, what seems like forever. And we have seen a lot happen. We have seen God work in the midst of our darkness. We work among one of the most unreached tribes in Guinea called the Fulani. They spread over the whole of the along the Niger River. Most of them are cattle herders and farmers. And in Guinea, they become businessmen and leaders in society. And so we're reaching a very different group. Their language is very difficult, so they've been kind of hard to reach. Other places, the herdsmen out on the deserts, they're hard to reach. And so there's not too many that have ever heard of the name of Jesus. Mark and I had first gone to Guinea to work with the refugees. And in the refugee camps, we were asked to come alongside Comma Services. I don't know if you've heard that. We were asked to join the relief agency of the Alliance to come alongside them and to bring the gospel to the refugee camps. We saw thousands come to know Christ in the refugee camp. Thousands. Praise God. Our job was to start churches in the camps, in the 52 camps, and then to train leaders. All the pastors had been killed in Liberia and Sierra Leone. All the pastors. There wasn't one. And so we had to start and give training to them. God did amazing work in reaching people in the camps for his name. And it was good. After they went back to Liberia and Sierra Leone, they asked us what we wanted to do. We said, well, we believe that we have been called to pioneer missions, which means that we want to go to the front of the line where the gospel's never been. We want to push forward. And so they did. They put us in the mountain region working among the Fulani. The French call them Fula. They call themselves Fulbe. All right? Fulbe. You can call them either one of those will work. They are Muslim. And there's only 100 believers in all of the country. And in our region, just maybe 10 that are actually following the Lord and seeking the Lord. And we've been there since 2000, plugging away. And we've come here today because I have been challenged by our team leader that if we get people praying, then we can make a larger difference than what we have done in the past. We have 2 years before retirement. We want to see the gospel go to the region beyond, okay? And when we're done with our region, we need to pray that God would send forth more workers to the region beyond us, because there's a whole region beyond us that's never had the gospel. And we drove through there, and we were praying through there that God would send workers into the region. My job here today is to first represent Jesus Christ and all that he has done in and through us in Guinea, West Africa, and also to present the new face of Alliance. We are the Christian and Missionary Alliance here. And we have Christians with missionaries joining together to reach the world. Okay? Now, my job's a big job today. I'm to teach you, make sure you know how to pray, how to give, and how to go. All right? Big task? All right. So here's what we have, regions beyond, so that you might preach the gospel to the regions beyond you. And that's our heart, that God would, through maybe today, raise up workers and givers who will beyond help them to go with the regions beyond. Wish he had a song, Regions Beyond. Next. Okay, you're going to see these four little symbols there. They're the new look. It's not hard to understand. The hand is for comma services. It's hands-on relief. I'll share more about that. M&M is the market ministry. That's businessmen reaching businessmen. X marks the spot. This is where we're targeting with the missionaries and church planting and ministries. The eyeglass is looking for leaders who we can help in their leadership training and help them get to the field through our prayers and through our schools. This is what we do. We serve. We're called to serve people, all right? In a Muslim nation, we can't go in as evangelists. We cannot go in as church planters, all right? They will kick us out. So we go in to serve the country. In Sunday school, we are able to share some of the ways we share with eyeglass clinics and with burn care, teaching English, teaching the children, just serving the community. Multiplying church networks, we gathered the believers that were there, and a church was started. Praise God. Praise God. There are about 20 there worshiping. It's grown from 20 to about 50 now that are worshiping on a Sunday. A good 20 of those are kids. And worshiping the Lord on Sunday. Most of those believers, though, are not from the Fulani. Most of those are from the other regions of Guinea who are Christians that have come to work in the area. But we've challenged them to reach out. We'd be sharing a little bit more. We also develop people. When Muslims come to Christ, they usually come to Christ one by one by one. And so it's a long process of helping them grow. Serving communities, go ahead. I made that larger. And it's not larger now. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I'll let you read it. All that means is that we have used our gifts. Now, when we first went to Guinea into our region, which is called Timbi Medina, we had just heard that Campus Crusade had been there trying to show the Jesus movie, Jesus film, and they threw rocks at them till they had to stop and leave. So we knew we weren't going to be able to do the same thing that we had done in the camps. The refugee camps, we put up a big screen, showed Jesus film, had music. We just weren't going to be able to do evangelism the same way. We had to do it differently. So we began to pray as we went to language school to learn the language. Onjarama, Tanala, Tanakamon, He. You're supposed to say He. That's yes, okay. He, all right. And we learned how to dress. Now, we have some people that have helped me. Yes, yeah, stand up, ladies, would you? Huh? Come up and model. Okay. Beautiful, huh? They want to see you. Well, the first thing I had to learn was to dress like them. And I thought one day I'll go to the market and I'll dress like them. I'll just see what happens, right? If I just put on their kind of dress and the headgear, what would happen? I was amazed. Everybody was so friendly. And when they found out I could speak their language, they invited me home to tea. And I had all kinds of wonderful opportunities just by dressing like them. Now, these things are really uncomfortable. Aren't they really uncomfortable? No, not too bad. Oh, all right.
Comfortable, they're tight, but they're comfortable.
All right, let's give a hand to our ladies. Thank you, ladies. Is that we left it back? So, with the learning the language, learning how to dress, learning their culture. And then we started praying, God, how are we going to reach them? How are we going to serve them? And God said, Moses, what's in your hand? And we said, for Moses it was a rod. For Mark it's nursing and computers, all right? For me it was teaching English and children's clubs and women's development and serving the women. And so he says, well, let's use this. For our other partner, Josie's dad, it was soccer, all right? He got the youth together and had a great youth ministry. Some of the strongest believers came from the youth ministry to soccer. He had to leave. It's got a hole there. I told the Spanish people, they said, oh, we love soccer. So maybe they'll come out and come to this Victory Center there. Praise God, huh?
Praise God.
And Our team member's daughter is here. That's why I'm pointing over here. Josie Stan. We're pretty excited to meet up again after so long. It was a great time ministering together. We're again by ourselves in Timbi Medina, and we miss him a lot. But we are moving forward. After language study, we started into these different ministries, and that's how we learned to serve the community, through burn care, through eyeglass clinics. My husband shared how we got into eyeglass clinics They just have no opportunity for glasses when they need it. And my biggest joy, I think, has been a tailor, you know, just a pair of reading glasses, and I can restore to him his livelihood. It's a joy to serve the people. But as we serve, we share Jesus. Amen. Okay? Amen. That's why we're here. That's why we're there. Next. Mark showed you Lightning Hawa and got that story there. Yes. Me teaching class next. Yeah. Okay. So we demonstrate through our serving the love of God. Next. English class. That was Obama. You've heard a little bit about Obama? Okay. This young man that's sitting beside me there in the checked shirt was an English student who decided that he liked the fact that an African-American became president. And so he chose Obama as a nickname. God did wonders in this man's life and heart. He came to Christ when he had been robbed of his computer. He was a college student studying computer, and thieves had clubbed him on his motorcycle and stolen his backpack and his computer and took off running. And he tried to run after him but couldn't make it, and he came to English class just so dejected. He lost his computer, and I says, let's pray. I believe that God hears and answers prayer. He loves you. He wants you to know him. Let's pray and see what God would do. So we prayed, and then he went back to where he had been robbed and started walking through the bush the way they had run. Guess what, folks? He found it, and it was fine. It was not harmed, even though thrown in the bushes. And he came back, and he says, you have the truth. I want to follow Christ. And so we began Bible studying with him, and he came to faith in Christ. Praise God. Answered prayer. Next. We serve communities in meaningful ways. All right? This is what our hope is. The mayor of the city says, Mark has the key to the city. All right? And we've been ministering there. We have earned their trust. We have earned their respect. And it is a great honor to be a part of their society and have a place in their society. Regions beyond. Let's keep going. Church networks. We started this little church. They didn't have a pastor for a long time. We just had a couple of elders that preached on Sunday. And now something wonderful has happened. Next. The goal and the alliance is to multiply churches, not just start one church, but have that church to start other churches, right? So this first church is of a group of what we call forest believers. They're from the south. They're from animistic tribes. They speak a different language. It is hard for them to minister to the Fulbe. They don't even speak the same language. Their customs are different. They don't even like each other. Okay? So to get them to reach out has been a long process. But God has worked. God has changed hearts. Next, please. And God is working. The first thing that God has done in Guinea, before we even came, the first missionaries came to a region called Konkan. And this year we celebrated the 100th anniversary of the first missionaries coming to Guinea. All right? The church is 100,000 strong among the forest people. Okay? And we were there at their celebration in Konkan. And they took a collection to send out missionaries to these other tribes that have never heard. Is that beautiful, folks?
Yes.
Gorgeous. Out there, my heart was so touched that here they are finally getting the vision of reaching out. So, next. So it's happening. All this is there. You can read it. It's happening in Guinea. Praise God. Oh, more. Multiplying church networks, spirit-empowered church networks are established among them. That's how the Great Commission works. This is the one I want you to see. This is Pastor Jacob and his family standing there beside him. This is one of the missionaries that they have sent out. The National Church has sent to our region as a missionary. Is that cool or what, folks? The National Church has sent them to our region. His name is Jacob. He has six children. His wife knows a little Pular, a little bit more than he does. And we've been out visiting. Before I left, she says, I want to know all the believers. You have to take me to every one of their houses. There's no address. There's no street names. You got to take them there. And so we went. She went with me, even though she was quite 8 months along. And she went with me to all these houses. And we did Bible studies with them. And so she's following up there. The young man in orange is Pastor Jacob's son. He's a senior. He's been helping me with the children's programs, so he'll be able to carry that on. And Pastor Jacob, bless him, pray he'll learn their language, Pular. He also, next one, he also is responsible to earn his own way. He's called a tent maker. They provide a little bit, but not enough. And so he has to make furniture to sell, to provide for his family, a tent maker missionary. And so he's there working a lot, making furniture. That's right in front of our computer center. Muslim people will not allow the church to own land or to build a church. And so they are meeting in our computer center. What happens after we leave, we don't know yet. So we are praying about that. God would provide them a place to meet. Next. Regions beyond, keep going. Third thing we're involved with is developing people. We evangelize through serving. We form into groups, churches that will reach out to other people. But our biggest job is to develop people. Next. We want to develop those who will disciple others with a passion for Jesus. A passion to be effective leaders in their communities. Next, here's Obama, getting baptized, in the river there. No alligators came. That's great. Cracks. All right. Next, and here he is. He has to earn a living too. He has a little taxi, three-wheel taxi there to help bring in the produce from the fields to the town to sell it on market day. Next. Okay, developing people, we invest in the holistic transformation of these individuals, physically, intellectually, emotionally, and spiritually, and who in turn play a role in the transformation of others and lead effective and networks of churches. What you don't see in this picture with Obama was that after that other incident, after he had come to Christ, he had a horrible motorcycle accident. He hit his head in a tree. Got bashed in pretty badly. He spent a year in bed. He had to learn to talk again, to walk again. And he forgot all his English. Sad. But we went to visit him, and we kept praying with him. And we have walked through this last years of healing. And now, because of God's faithfulness, he's able to read fluently. He's able to memorize the Bible stories, and he has a heart of passion for the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. God has done this. God has done this. Transformed this young man, healed his body, and now he wants to serve God. He goes to our eyeglass clinics, and he's not afraid to say, I'm going to pray for you in the name of Jesus. God answers his prayer. People are healed. It's amazing. We're just watching God work through this young man. We would earnestly pray that you will join us in prayer for him, that God would protect him, move him. God, he wants a wife, a Christian wife. If it sounds familiar, we had another man the same thing. His name was Ansemann, another one of my students who came to Christ. He had a club foot. I asked doctors if it could be healed. He says he's too old, it can't. And I said, but he kept coming to me saying, Ma'am D, can God heal my foot? And I said, yes, he can. But he doesn't always do it when you want him to. Mm-hmm. Keep praying. 5 years passed, 10 years passed. Ma'am D, can God heal my foot? I said, yes, he can. Let's keep praying. Let's keep trusting. 15 years passed, and God provided a way for his foot to be operated on. He came back radiant. Ma'am D, look, I can walk straight. Praise God. God is working in Guinea. Dark, poor, hopeless. God is working in their midst. Hallelujah. He too wanted a Christian wife, or he wanted a wife. His family was going to give him a Muslim wife. We said, Ansemann, that's not God's way. Trust God for a Christian wife. Finally, he got to the point where he says, Ma'am D, I'm going to trust God for a Christian wife. And if I have to be single all my life, it's okay. I am the street preacher. Huh? Hello? God gave him a Christian wife. Long story about him. Her name is Sabina. She came to Christ through the English Center in Conakry with our English Youth Center that's in Conakry. And they came together. They're serving God now on the Mercy Ship, which is a hospital, a Christian hospital that travels from port to port. They're serving God now. Praise God.
Praise God.
So God is working. Oh, I'm so excited. I got to get one. Next, please. We want to see multiplying churches, okay? This is where you guys come in, all right? Because our field leader challenged us this year to raise 1,000 people to pray. And the reason is that the mission had asked him to go into Burkina Faso to a new region and to bring the gospel to a region that had never heard, okay? And so he felt in his heart that God wanted him to get 1,000 people praying. It actually came from contagious discipleship making, that if you really want to see a church planting movement, to get at least 1,000 people praying for you. So God helped him raise up 1,000 people to pray for him. He and his wife, they went to this region. And you know what they found? Open doors. They'd go into a village, they would sit down with the chief. They would say, Chief, we want to come and bring truth to your village. We want, and people will believe in Jesus Christ. We will form a church. There'll be much trouble and strife in your village. What do you say? He says, the chief says, we must have the truth. We must have the truth. They have their evangelism crusade in front of everyone. People come to Christ. They form a church. Time after time after time. What a difference. You guys, I'm tired. You know, this one and one is okay, but it's, you know, it's a long process. I would so love to have open doors to that level where we can share openly and see the church raised up quickly. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
And that's where you come in. I need people to pray. Join with us in prayer that God would move in mighty ways and open doors. All right? I'm going to go through some steps in prayer in a minute. Go on. Oh, I got to do this. Okay. The hand represents comma. How to give, the first step, all right? How to give to the Alliance. Keep going. Comma Services is our relief organization. It's already helping with the hurricane relief. You've heard of Ebola? It was in Guinea. Comma was there. All right? Comma was there. Comma is still there providing follow-up and help with all those families that were just torn apart. Because what happened in the villages is if a family got Ebola, they evicted the whole family. They lost their homes, they lost their lands, they won't let them go back. They said, it's your fault. That death came to our village. And so the Common Services is helping with getting the churches mobilized to help all these victims and the orphanages for them. All right? Comma, you can be proud of the Alliance folks. They're doing a great job. They're an absolutely great job. This last year, another picture there. This last year, they've gone beyond, and they are giving Rob Reimer Soul Care seminars and conferences for the pastors just to renew their heart. And oh, this time there, 425 pastors came to this, and God did amazing ministry among those pastors in the forest region to get their hearts right with God. And we're praying for revival to break out. And not just to the forest region, but those other three Muslim cultures, languages that are in the country. There's not just the Fulani, there's the Malinke, there's the Susu. Three of them are Muslim in Guinea. And the others are just about unreached. It's crazy what the work is. Okay, keep going. Marketplace ministry is businessmen helping businessmen find Christ. And they have seminars for business. Teachers go out. One guy he's an auto mechanic, right? And so he's come out from England. He works in the trade center teaching students how to fix cars. But he's there sharing Christ. Praise God. Amen. And it's through marketplace ministry. So you have a trade. You're a nurse. You're a doctor. You can go. All right? With your trade, there's a place for you. So if you want to go, there is a place. All right? Even a professional can go. Sign up 2 years, whatever, and go under this auspice, all right, with the Alliance. It's possible, okay? Praise God, huh? Yeah. Access, that's X marks the spot. That's where we are, different places in the world, some we can't even tell you about because it's too dangerous if we tell you. But God has helped us. The Alliance is doing a huge job at getting us out to those regions that are unreached, all right? We need help of the church, our churches, praying that God would send out what? Workers where? Into the fields and beyond. Amen. Go on. This is the church that was started in Timi Medina. They like to dress. They like to sing, do the African shuffle. When, you know, my husband can't clap and sing at the same time, so he just stands there. But the rest of us like to dance and sing. And this is me giving a Bible study to a little lady that's come to Christ in the next village over. She has come to faith in Christ. Two of her children have come to faith in Christ. We're praying for her husband to come to faith in Christ. But we go regularly to teach them the Bible, story by story. Here's a neighbor. That's my back porch and her grandbaby. And we're praying for her salvation. One of her sons has come to faith in Christ through soccer.
Who is she?
Laura Tu is her name.
You?
Yeah, me. I'm in the black there. And I'm not the black one. I'm in the black. Yeah. The black shirt.
That's you?
That's me.
You look younger, right?
Huh? Yeah, it was pretty hot there. It's pretty hot. That's Gondo's mom, Josie. Okay. Yeah. So Gondo came to Christ through Josie's dad's ministry with soccer, and I'm trying to reach the mother and the rest of the family with Bible storing. Okay. Here's the kids. There's Obama in front helping. Every year we have revision classes. Okay. Keep going. Envision is trying to raise up the next generation of people to come. And so we give opportunities for them to come. If you want to come and join us for a short-term thing, you can. with the eyeglass clinics, if you're a nurse, if you want to help with the children's ministries, you can. All right? You can come. Come for a week or two, nine days. Come and we'll put you to work. All right? And you're welcome. You're welcome. It's quite a bit to come. You got to have shots. But we want you protected. And you can be involved with it. These are different ways that you can give to the Alliance. They wanted to make sure that all those things are under the Alliance. We talk about the Great Commission Fund. The Great Commission Fund is what puts food on my table, folks, and thank you very much. I like to eat. And sometimes we have to order food 3 months at a time because the Capitol is 9 hours away, and we don't go every week. You know, we don't go there for, you know, this or that. So we have to plan ahead. And then the fuel in our car is for Great Commission. How many give to the Great Commission Fund? Can I see your hands? All right, I want to say thank you. All right, I'll give you hugs afterwards, all right? You come up for a hug. I have a card here. If you want to pray, if you want to be a prayer partner, one of those thousand, make sure your name and email address gets in this little book. It says stick to it. All right? Next one. Here's one church or some teens that came out for an eyeglass clinic. I've been able now. This was a new village. Eyeglass clinics is a way we start into a new village. All right? So because everybody leaves happy, you know? And so we started here. I've been following up with this lady who is the head of the clinic there, La Marana. And I've been able to have Bible study with her and follow up after the eyeglass clinic. And it's a beautiful time. So, yeah, your church, bring a group. You can do this with us. All those 10,000 pairs of glasses, we need someone to help find the one we want. Okay, next one. These are the hills beyond us, folks. Lobby region. The regions beyond. Thank you for your part in supporting the church. When are you supposed to stop?
Whenever you decide.
Okay, I could go on another hour.
They can all leave.
If you have pencil and paper, you might want to jot these things down. God gave me this morning on how to pray, things specific. To pray not only for Mark and I, but pray for your pastor. In December, I was reading Revelation, trying to read the Bible all the way through, you know, and trying to finish Revelation in December. We were doing a lot of traveling. It was difficult. And I read the first part of Revelation. It talks about the church here, and then the church here, and the church here, seven churches, right? And I began to ask God, why you talk about the churches and then Revelation to come. Why talk about those seven churches? And in those seven churches, God talks about something that's happening in them. He says, you've done good here, but you still have this to do. And I began to ask God, you know, what's with, you know, why did you put that in the beginning of Revelation? And finally, you know, it hit me. That those seven qualities that God is dealing with each of those churches there just might be some quality that is important to God. It is important to us to be ready for the end times. Okay? So I haven't finished this study, but I have pinpointed ways to pray, seven ways to pray, so that we can be ready. Ready, folks, for the end times. You know, we have Muslims, the radical Muslims in Mali, the next country over. It's not that far away before they are in our area, in the mountain region. We may face them. Are we ready to go? Are we ready? Yeah. Are you ready for the end times yourself? Okay. So I'm going to give you these seven things. They're taken from those different churches. I have to give them to you quickly. loving God. Number one, loving God. Love the Lord with all your heart, your soul, your mind, and your strength. That didn't mean much to me. So I thought about it. The heart is your desires. Your soul is your decision-making area of your life. Your mind is your thoughts. Your strength is your actions. So love the Lord with all your desires. Love the Lord with all your decisions. Love the Lord with all your thoughts. Love the Lord with all your actions. That makes a whole lot more sense to me, right? So when you pray for missionaries, pray for your pastor, pray for yourselves, pray for your church, that God would teach us to love with all our desires, to love God with all our desires, with all our decisions we make, with all our thoughts, with all our actions, that God would teach us to love him and then love others as ourselves, to reach out to others. I don't know if you guys have an international, you have Spanish, yeah, in this book. You have other people at the school, Haitians, reach out, love them. If you don't know how to reach out to them, just, you know, if I were them, what would I like? And you minister to them. Love, number one, that we will love greatly with all our heart, soul, mind, and strength. Number two, faithful, that we'll be faithful unto death. You know, the climate is hot. We don't have electricity a lot of the time. There are lots of diseases. You know, there are a lot of things we deal with all the time. It just goes with the job. But pray that we will be faithful. We won't let the heat or the rain or the mud stop us. That we will move forward. Be faithful. The third one is to repent. And it has different things to repent of. And when I thought about repenting of those things, it really boiled down to indulgences. Repent of indulgences. Since coming back from Africa, I'm really amazed at the idolatry in the United States. You know, people worship, it seems, comfort and pleasure more than God. And pray that us, okay, wouldn't get caught up and those small indulgences. You know, I got to confess, I got caught the other day. I saw a shirt. It was my birthday, right? And I was in the store, and I saw this shirt that I really wanted, you know? I gave in. I said, Mark, I really want that shirt. And he got it for me. It was my birthday, right? And later I thought, why? I don't really need it. Indulgence. It hits us so easily here. You know, it's so easily. You can't hardly get away from them. Pray that we will have a heart tender toward God, that we won't give in to indulgence of comfort or pleasure, but we will go the road. For yourself, pray the same thing. For your pastor, for your each other. Pray that you won't give in to this idolatry of indulgence. It's in the Word of God. It's not really me. Okay, forgive me if I step on toes here. I don't usually do that. Fourth one is do God's will. Okay? Pray that we will do God's will. We will take the time to hear his voice and do what he asked us to do. No more, no less. But we will do, we will act as God leads us. Fifth one, that you will be dressed in white. And you say, what? Dressed in white? Right? Say, huh? Huh? Dressed in white? It says it right there. Revelation 3:26, dressed in white. And I read a little further on to find out what they're talking about. And it was talking about those that have not stained their clothes. Those who are dressed in the robe of righteousness. Okay? Jesus says, be holy. God says, be holy as I am holy. Walk before him in holiness. So pray for that. Pray that we would stay clear with a clear conscience before God. Pray for yourselves for the same. You cannot be ready to serve God. You cannot stand against the enemy if you have sin in your heart and in your life. So stay pure. The next one is to walk before me, kept by my word, and do not deny my name. If you're not writing them down, if you want to go, they're the churches in Revelation. Each, there's seven of them, and you pinpoint what God is wanting you to pray for. The last one is for open doors. Pray that God would open doors. And that we would have the boldness and the courage to walk through those open doors that God gives us. And what we're going to see, if you pray this for us, is the doors opening before us to new regions. For those rest of the region where we are, Tembe, Medina, and to the region beyond us. All right? I got to stop. I'm not finished, but I got to stop. Right? My book. All right? If you feel God leading you to be one of those thousand, make sure your email address or someone's is in this little book. And I don't know about giving an invitation, but if someone is called today to pray, be a part of prayer, would you raise your hand? Just let me see that. Oh, good. All right. Okay, the book's in front here. You can sign it. All right. My prayer cards are on the table in the back. And was there anyone that came to church today with just a burning desire saying, I got to know Jesus? My life is falling apart and I have to know Jesus. Anybody come to church with that? Raise your hand tall. One, two, three. Afterwards, would you come up front and let us talk? All right, Pastor, we got someone who can talk with them too.
Our elders will be up front.
Okay, elders meet. Come, all right? If you want to know Jesus, if you've got a burden, a life, a situation that you want to see God work and move, come pray with us. All right? God is there. And when you guys pray, pray expectantly. He's going to answer. If he can heal Ansem Osman's foot, if he can heal Obama's head, all right, and give him a Christian wife where there is no possibility of a Christian wife, he can hear our prayers, all right, and he can work in your life as well and in this church. God bless you all.
Stand with me, please. What we'll do is we'll put that prayer book in the back.
Okay.
Okay. And then people that will want to go sign up can sign up. Would you like to be up here or would you like to be back there? Because we can ask you to be back there if you want.
Well,
or do you want to be?
Well, if you're going to talk with the people here, I can be back.
Yes. Okay. Exactly. We have elders that are always up here. Okay. What I'd like to do is I'd like to say a little prayer of thanksgiving for you. And then if you would, in language, would you pray over us?
Sure.
Yeah. Let's pray. Father Heaven, we're just so grateful, Father, for the way in which you have continued to work in Mark and Dee's life. Father, we're thankful that they have gone into a different region, Father, and Father, their hearts are for the regions beyond. And Father, I take great pride, if I can say it that way, in partnering with them, that this church works with them, side by side with them. And Father, we know that they are sometimes in the forefront of danger, in the forefront of disease. Father, we pray for their continued protection. Father, might your spirit continue to inspire them and guide them and lead them into a way, Father, that just continues to serve you with righteousness. Father, I pray the blood upon them, Father, that even when they walk into a village, even when they serve someone, Father, that's a burn victim or an eyeglass clinic, or when she is speaking to a woman, Father, I would pray that the light of Christ is seen just in by their actions and the things that they do and the way that they serve their community. Father, continue the light to shine. Father, I pray for their future. Father, I pray as they're going to continue to speak into some other churches and then go back. Father, I would pray that their return is well received. And Father, that they do not have to worry, that you have all things under control. Continue to lead and inspire them. We pray your blessing upon them in the name of your Son. Amen. And if you would pray for us, dear, I'd appreciate it. Thank you.
Put your hands like this to pray in the Muslim way. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Muslim believers. Baba jo amen. Onja rama. Kofi giko maum. Onja rama. Kofi fo ala no jonu de amen. Onja rama. Kofi aloko walu de Obama. E ansema. O Allah. Onja rama. Kofi giko maum. Mintoro de alahande o baba jo. Kofi jonu de gigo maon e hore yembe benghande. Me toro de ala e nabi Isa. Amina.
Amen. God bless you. Thank you so much. Amen. I understand. Amen. All right, sir. You the man? Jess?
Okay.
Amen. At this time, we receive the morning tithes and offerings. And while the gentlemen are coming forward, if you would like to go to Guinea, West Africa, here's what you do. Take your boat, go out here to the Atlantic, and go southeast 4,000 miles. You'll be in their neighborhood. You say, how did you know that, Jess? I didn't know you were that intelligent. No, I was in Sunday school this morning, and they told us how to do it. Amen? So be in Sunday school next week and gain some wisdom. But it is, isn't it marvelous, though, that here we are in West Palm, God sends his servants over to tell us what God is doing 4,000 miles away with these people working with. So let's get, yes, please. Just about every one of us raised our hand. Let's remember our missionaries in prayer. Father, we give you the praise and the glory. You are an awesome God, a mighty God. We're so thankful, Father, that you have drawn us here this day, right here in this sanctuary. Father, where we could praise and worship you, and Father, where we could hear the voice of a missionary who has dedicated her life to you and her husband, Lord, and the work that you are doing in that Muslim country, Lord. Oh, I just pray, oh God, as they continue working with these people, many precious souls would come to know who the Lord Jesus Christ is. And Father, it's through the finances that are given through our churches, God, that this work can continue on. So help us to catch that vision. See where we fit, Father. We give you the praise and the glory. Father, as we receive the tithes and the offerings now, I just pray, oh God, that you'll bless the gift, the giver alike, in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Your love defends me. Yeah.
surely my God is the strength of my soul. Your love defends me. Your love defends me. And when I feel like I'm all alone, your love defends me. Your love defends me. We sing
Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that we can so easily become entangled with. And let us run with perseverance the race marked out before us, fixing our eyes on, do you know the name? Fixing our eyes on Jesus. Do you know the name? Fixing our eyes on
Jesus.
God bless you. Go serve your King.